went through all those files and found Zip.
There's gotta be a loophole somewhere. Procedure that was missed, a place where Michael's rights weren't protected, something.
Yeah, well, the trial was pretty chaotic. I don't know if we can get any mileage out of that.
Sonny's trial was chaotic. Michael's confession was straightforward. He wasn't coerced. He knew exactly what he was saying. The judge questioned him himself. He didn't even try and trip him up. I mean, sure as hell made him pay.
You know what? From a legal standpoint, 5 years with a chance of parole after two, it's not that bad for manslaughter.
Yeah, but it's a disaster for Michael being a death sentence.
Yeah, I know. We played our part in making it happen. That's why we gotta get him out.
So you didn't read Michael's rights when you picked him up?
No, technically, Michael wasn't under arrest, so I didn't want anything he told me to be admissible in court.
Mac read him his rights. There's nothing here. You know, I should have just dropped him off as soon as I got off the plane. He could have talked to Diane. She could have cut a deal.
Why didn't you do that?
Because I wanted to save my brother. I wanted to do it my way.
Who's the judge now?
Gentlemen.
Afternoon, Judge.
Yes, sir. I'm here for a meeting with the commissioner, but I wanted to thank you for your work. The case of Michael Corinthos III is closed, detectives. I hope you're not wasting time looking for loopholes.
No disrespect, Judge, but I think your sentence is harsh, like I told you.
Well, don't second guess yourself. Don't blame yourself for turning him in. You probably saved his life.
That is all I was ever trying to do.
Yeah, you're a good cop, Detective Falconeri. You honor the badge and the responsibility that goes with it. Unlike Detective Spencer, who seems to uphold the law only when it suits him.
When I turned my brother in, I told the truth. I trusted the system, but my brother does not belong in prison. Please, I am asking you to reconsider.
I did not enjoy sending a teenager to a maximum security penitentiary, particularly when this travesty could have been so easily avoided.
Michael's father has a lot of enemies at Pentonville, and you know that, sir.
Sonny Corinto seems to have enemies everywhere. Michael needs to see firsthand the darker side of how his father makes a living. He'll understand the folly of wanting to join the Corinthos crime syndicate.
Yeah, if he lives that long.
Okay, a suspended sentence with community service and counseling would have had the same effect, with less risk to Michael.
Your brother took a human life. Despite all his protestations about wanting to confess, he went right along with the cover-up. Anything less than 5 years would have been irresponsible.
He needs help.
Michael had all kinds of opportunities to get help. Far more than most criminals that have come before me.
Michael's not a criminal.
Yeah, he is. Killing his stepmother could be the start of a career just like his father's. This time in prison could be Michael's best chance to turn his life around.
I hope you are right, sir.
So do I. Good day.
That guy's gonna reverse his sentence.
Ah, he just needs a little encouragement, that's all.
What are you thinking?
Well, it's not gonna be pretty, but it could work. I'm not suggesting that we plant evidence or make anything up, but everyone has dirty laundry somewhere. All we have to do is find Judge Carroll's. We let him know we have it. He gets to make a choice. He can reverse himself, or we hang the judge. And all of his dirty little secrets out to dry.
Jason will never blame himself or Sonny or Carly.
I'm probably alive because of Carly, remember?
Absolutely, absolutely. But Jason, it's not fair for him to blame you for Michael being in prison when you were honestly trying to help your brother.
I just wanted to thank you for being such a great father to Jake. You know, it really helps me to know that he's going to grow up safe with two parents that really love him.
When do you think you're going to be leaving?
Within 24 hours.
Okay, look, Jason, I have a lot of respect for what you're doing, but I am partly responsible for Michael being there, and I'm telling you, I'm going to do everything I can on my end to make this right.
Carly swears that Dante's safe from you.
Yeah, Mom, I don't know what to tell you. I know that you chose Dante over a lot of people who love you and who trusted you. I guess you have to live with that.
What the hell was that?
Just don't worry about it.
Well, no, I'm not just gonna stand by and let some thug throw attitude a loop.
Hey, that thug is sending himself to prison to protect Michael. which is a hell of a lot more than any of us are doing.
Well, I gotta admit, I'm relieved. I'm not no fan of Jason's, but at least Michael's gonna have some company in Pentonville.
You'll be a lot safer with Jason locked up, so I'm relieved too.
And that guy's walking the walk, I guess. Just doing something to help Michael instead of sitting around talking about it.
Where are you going with this?
Lucky and I are looking for some dirt on Judge Carroll. And I think I know who might be able to help us.
It's about time.
No, this is a great time. I hate paperwork. My gorgeous daughter. So good to see you, baby.
I'm just happy that you're speaking to me.
Why wouldn't I? Oh, that thing with Dante. Look, okay, so Dante made an unpopular choice and you've chosen to stand by him. Deal with the fallout.
I am. I'm going to be doing damage control. Do you have any good dirt on that judge, Peter Carroll?
Peter Carroll. Not that I know about, but I'll ask around.
Okay. Yeah, Dante and Lucky are trying to blackmail him into reversing Michael's sentence, so...
Well, that sounds promising. Bring me up to date here. Is it true that Dante went into the courtroom and announced that it was Michael who killed Claudia?
Yes. Dante's trying to save Michael. It's Sonny's fault that Michael's life is this long, slow-motion train wreck.
Yeah, well, Sonny is who he is, Lulu. And like it or not, he is Dante's father. And deep down, that will always matter.